Greetings, Earthlings. Excuse my washer. I thought it was going to stop. Anyway, I am going to make a fantabulous dessert. So what I'm doing is preparing a jelly roll pan. Of course, I need two hands to do that, but I've buttered it with unsalted butter, and now I'm going to sprinkle it pretty good with flour, and then I'll show you the recipe. So when you flour something, you know, get the flour all around. You know I can't do this because there's no room for the tripod in here. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is just finish coating the bottom of the pan with flour, and I'm going to tap out all the excess. I'll even drop the pan a couple times so I can make sure I don't have lots and lots of flour stuck in the pan, which might make the recipe taste kind of pasty where it's on the pan. So if you ever have that problem with cakes or cookie bars or anything that you have to use butter and flour, or lard and flour, or whatever and flour to grease and prepare the pan, always tap out the excess flour. Otherwise you could get that raw, gummy, sticky, overcooked pasta flavor. Okay, so we're making banana bars. Yeah, I know, bananas don't like me, but they love hungry hubby. So I've been such a neglectful wife since I just never feel good. I thought today I'm feeling pretty good, so let's make him a treat. And it's not a great big recipe, but it is a delicious recipe. What I have in here is a cup and a half of white sugar and one stick of unsalted butter. It's important not to use salted butter. I can tell the difference. You've heard me lecture you on this before. I mean, if you really want to use it, just omit the salt in the recipe or cut back, way back on the salt in the recipe. And then add some other flavoring so you can hide that rancidity that is prevalent in salted butter. Okay, so my butter was not at room temperature, but it's getting there. So I'm just going to cream it until it's light and fluffy, and I'll come back when that's done. Not yet. It's getting there. Okay, so next we're going to put in two large chicken eggs. One at a time. When it's all mixed in, then you can add the next one. That's one mixed in. Show you the difference. This is Lucerne sour cream. It's soupy. It always is soupy. Dairy Gold. Dairy Gold. Thick. This is the kind I like, but oh, that hurts. It's got probiotics, but it's got cream, milk, whey, modified cornstarch, blah, 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 blah. Anyway, and to add, you know, some extra interesting non-dairy ingredients, it has locust bean gum. I like it thick, but not really like that. So, two hands, I'm going to scrape this out with the rubber spatula. I am a scraper. I don't believe in measuring and then leaving half the ingredients in your container that you measured into. So, I need two hands for this. Meanwhile, back at the farm, you need about a cup of mashed bananas. Why is this so wet? That's how I like them. Let them get nice and brown. The ones that, you know, nobody will eat because they're freckled. throw it in the freezer, and then it's great for your muffins, quick breads, cakes, cupcakes, banana nut bread. It really adds a lot of moistness, a lot more sweetness, and just delectable yumminess. So this is about two medium-large, maybe. Oh, maybe one was medium and one was medium-large. I don't know. Never measured them. Okay, so it's all in there and on the stove and on the floor and on top of Scruffy's head and on my shoe. But that's okay. You know I'm a klutz. So you want to, like, put it on low, kind of stir it in. That's enough. Ooh, I guess now we need about a teaspoon of swill. Okay, so that's a little more than a teaspoon. But it's so good. If you don't have swill, use vanilla. Alright, so on a piece of parchment or wax paper or in a big bowl, but you know me, I'm lazy. You just want to sift 2 cups of all-purpose flour, a teaspoon of soda, and a quarter teaspoon of salt. So, this is another two-hand job. I'll tell you why I'm having so much trouble. This thumb, I can't bend. If it does bend, it gets stuck, and I have to, like, force it back into position. It's swollen all the time. I always have a pain patch on it, unless, of course, I'm making banana bars. The other hand is the one that I broke when I broke my arm and thumb and wrist and whatever. So I'm pretty much wiped out. I just can't seem to get a break. And dealing with pain and not dealing with pain medications, ouch. You know, that's kind of hard, but I don't want to take pain meds. You know, I really don't. I know it's a permanent situation, so do I want to take pain meds for the rest of my life? Be like wackadoodles or something? No. Alright, so all this junk is sifted. And now I'm going to stir in a third at a time the flour mixture into the creamed sugar, butter, and eggs. And then when it's combined really nicely, I'm going to dump in my mushed up bananas, which should be about a cup. But it was 2 large bananas that were spotty, frozen, defrosted, and pushed out of their skins. It's important to do that. Okay, I'm stirring it in, so keep this parchment. You can use it when you make cookies next time. Ooh, I'm going to turn it off and scrape down the sides, and then I'm going to fold in or stir in on the lowest possible speed all the mushed up bananas. Okay, so counting everything I dropped all over the stove, that's about a cup of bananas. Now I'm going to stir it in, but I do need 2 hands again. Okay, it's all mixed in, so we'll give it one final scrape down with a rubber spatula. And then we'll spread it into the sheet pan, the jelly roll pan. Okay. Turn off, Mr. Alrighty, so before you dump it in your pan, if you're so inclined to use, you know, chopped nuts or whatever, go ahead. I'm going to have chopped nuts on top of the frosting, but not in the batter. Why? I don't know. Nuts don't like me so much. Okay, so use your offset spatula and spread it nice and even into the jelly roll pan. But don't do like me. Take it off of your parchment paper so it doesn't slide all over the place. Take your time. You can bake this also in a 9x13. I think it takes about 38 minutes, but at 350 degrees. This will take 20 to 25 minutes, so you start checking it at about 20 degrees. and, you know, you want the toothpick to come out clean, or skewer, in my case, I'm not using a toothpick, because if I did, I'd burn myself. All right, get it in the corners. When you're spreading things into corners, try not to drag it back, because that picks it up again, because you're floured, and just try to, you know, go in the corner direction without pulling it back. All right. I'm going to pop it in the 350-degree oven and check it at 20 minutes. Hopefully, it will be done before 25 minutes. Okay. Okay, while you're baking and cooling your banana bar batter, you want to get 8 ounces of cream cheese, Philly, of course. Now, I keep this in the freezer. When they go 99 cents a box, what did I spill now? When they go to 99 cents a box, I'll buy as many as I can and freeze them. They work out great for baking, frostings, and stuff like that. Not so much for a bagel, but definitely to use in baking and cream cheese frostings. So, I'm going to use 1/2 a stick of unsalted butter. This brick of cream cheese, 1 cup of confectioner sugar, and a little splash of swill, vanilla extract. So anyway, my BFF called me the other day. She goes, "Oh, I'm almost out of that stuff you gave me. Can I just add water to the jar?" I said, "No, you have to add vodka." "Vodka? I don't have vodka." I said, "I never have vodka either. But I make Hungry go to the store and get it for me." So, hopefully she didn't put water on top of her vanilla beans. Okay, so there it is out of the oven. It took 22 minutes and change. What am I listening to? That's Baby Gramps. He sang a song about getting baptized on backwater swamp or back swamp land water. Anyway, he's a local phenomena. He was on David Letterman. You can look him up. Baby Gramps. Okay. Although I didn't think that was his best music ever. Hungry's actually performed on stage with him. And Hungry's BFF. I don't guess guys call them BFFs. But anyway, we're going to let it cool completely while we move on to the cream cheese frosting. See, you wouldn't want to put that cream cheese on your bagel, but it really will make a wonderful the back swamp potioner. Anyway, you can make your icings with it and cookies and other baked goods. Okay, so here's the cream cheese frosting. Keep moving this thing. It's a coupon. I need it. 1/2 a stick of unsalted butter, 1 8-ounce package of Philly cream cheese, 1 cup or so of powdered sugar. I sifted mine because it was lumpy. Pinch of salt, did I say that? Just a little one-finger pinch. And a teaspoon of vanilla extract or swill. Have to add a teaspoon of milk or cream or something to it. We'll see. Looks like it'll be good. But you don't want to frost your banana bars until they're completely cool. I'll be back when this is nice and fluffy. Good grief, earthlings. I had to add like a whole extra cup of sugar in there. Because when I defrosted the cream cheese, it turned into cream cheese soup. It's okay, it'll work. You just have to whip it enough that it gets all the graininess out of it. Hey, it was only 99 cents. Yes, I'm still listening to Baby Gramps. Anyway, slicing up some walnuts. Because hungry hubby loves them. He don't like me, so that'll keep me from doing too much of a taste test on the banana bars. I'm just going to sprinkle it on the top. You can add like half cup of chopped or sliced nuts to your batter, but truthfully, I like it better if you just put it on top. Bananas don't like me either, but everything I do for him. Anyway, Mama Nisa, she started writing the blog. It is the funniest thing ever. Her kids are so hysterical. I know. And everybody tells her, write it down. You think you'll remember, but you won't. Okay. Okay, so just dump it on. Whoops. You think he's over? No. Okay. I have to scrape some more out. I'll be right back. Isn't this pretty? Anyway. I would say 36 pieces would be about right. This is incredibly rich. Lots of butter and cream cheese in it. And sour cream and eggs. So, you can always have the second piece if you want. Anyway, I'll show you a piece after we cut it. I am attempting to cut this. So I've cut 4 lines that way, and let's see, I have a crooked eye. Everything I hang on the wall looks like, you know, a kindergarten kid hung it up. Okay, so one time I made these for picnic we had about 5 million people. I should have made like 3 batches because they were going so fast. Ooh, that's crooked. That looks like the River Nile. Okay, so now it's 16, so I'm going to cut each of these in half again. Oops. Oops. 2 hands, people. So there you go. Very moist. Packing a couple up for my friend, the crafty lady. She doesn't eat anything that she considers unhealthy, but maybe she'll like these. At any rate, I'll bring them to her tomorrow. There you go, banana bars. I'll come back in a second for your review. Good?
Tastes very good.
Scale of 1 to 10?
Well, 10 and 3.75.
Not bad.